And what's happening, though, in Nashville now is this conversation is becoming real. It's a movement. There are people that are doing amazing things outside of just the artist. Todd Cassidy has Song Suffragettes every Monday night at the Listening Room, where I think 13 female artists have received publishing deals from this. You have the Girls of Nashville, who are the songwriters that bring in different songwriters and artists to perform on stage throughout Nashville 2 to 3 times a year. Artists, there's not a day goes by that I don't speak to an artist on every level. They're all going through the same thing, and now the artists are supporting each other. There are women that are now all tweeting, as Tracy said, they're supporting each other, so a win for one is a win for all. And so that's sort of the environment that we want to have, and that's where you guys come in, because you probably have ideas, whether you're a publicist or someone in radio here or a manager, that you can support the next generation. And Cam has been very vocal about it. That's why we're excited that she's here. So I wanted to kind of go into things before you moved here about gender inequality. And was there that one moment that you were like, wow, I didn't realize this was a real problem coming into it?
For me, I grew up in the San Francisco Bay Area. And so I feel very privileged to not really have known exactly what sexism was, and thought that wasn't really a thing that happened anymore. And then I came to Nashville, and I realized that it was confusing at first, because I kept trying to attribute issues to other things, or things people would tell me. I would think, oh, they've got to have a real reason. They can't be really saying that to my face. But they were. And the thing is that everybody has sort of been fed a lot of different myths, that women don't like listening to other women, which is not true. Women don't like buying music from other women, which is not true. That women, just somehow there's a vibe that like we can't break through things. And the truth is that we want to explain by the end of this is that we are 85% of the consumers, and we actually have the power already.
There was also that somewhere somebody said that women don't want to hear other women. There was no data, but that was often said to us, that was why radio wouldn't play women. So basically, we got together and realized, how do we break the cycle? What do we do? We wanted to turn our frustration into solutions. We started out and we got about 30 people together, men and women, agents and managers and artists, to figure out what we could do. Our intent was to do our own research, provide some education, and mainly encourage women to really support each other. We found that, you know, when you're told there's one slot available, I mean, whether you're a man or woman, it tends to make you very competitive. And we realized that that's what was happening, and we encouraged some of these young artists and writers that a win for one was a win for all, and that the best thing we could do is encourage them to support each other, tweet about each other, get on social platform, take each other out on tour, and that we would see really great results.
And they said I was creating a problem that didn't exist. Mm-hmm. But unfortunately, the numbers show differently. The lack of females on country radio, of course, is a well-documented trend that's been written about. But what's interesting is that women are making some of the best music in country today, and that's not my opinion. That's the opinion of voters of the ACMs, the Grammys, the critics who write their albums of the year. MTSU student Elena Knott conducted research into Billboard 2017's Year in Hot Country Songs list, and found that only 35 songs had a woman participating in some way, whether it was singing in a group or being featured in a man's song or writing a song. That means 65 of the songs are produced, written, and sung solely by men. In 2017, there were only 7 solo females in the top 100. That number jumps to 13 if you include Lady A, Little Big Town, and Tim and Faith. No woman was in the top 10, and only one woman was in the top 20, Carly Pierce. There were 22 men with more than one song in the top 100, but only 3 solo females. On the Billboard Year in Country Songs list, there were 163 male songwriters and only 29 female songwriters. 48 men had more than one song on the top 100, compared to 6 women. And of course, the worst numbers come in the production area. There were only 4 female producers. 3 of those were also the artists, so there was only one producer who was not the artist.